Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Pragati, and I'm working as an assistant professor in St. Martin's Engineering College. So today I will be giving a seminar on the types of the laser, or we call it as the pumping level schemes. So there are three different pumping level schemes are there: 2-level laser system, 3-level laser system, and the 4-level laser system. So after discussing the 2-level laser system, we will be going to the drawbacks, what we have at drawbacks under the 2-level laser system, and how we are resolving those drawbacks in the case of 3-level, and still the 3-level laser, if the drawbacks are any, how we are resolving by using a 4-level pumping scheme. So let's come to the 2-level pumping scheme. In a 2-level pumping scheme, we are only having the two energy levels, which are E1 and E2. The population on the first energy level will be N1. These are called the number of population of the atoms. And on the population on the second energy level will be some atoms, but always the population on the ground state will be more than the excited state. The ground state here is nothing but the energy level E1, and the excited state is the energy level E2. So we initially see what? Always the number of atoms on the ground state, the number of population of atoms on the ground state is always more than in the case of the excited state. So what is happening? So whenever we provide any external energy to the system, external energy is provided in the case laser medium. We keep a laser medium in the resonating cavity, and to that cavity and to that medium we provide the external energy. When we provide external energy, providing external energy is nothing but pumping the atoms. Whenever we are pumping the atoms, these atoms are excited to the energy level E2, and the pumping energy is H nu is equals to E2 minus E1. So whatever the pumping energy is provided, it should be equal to the difference between the two energy levels, which is nothing but E2 minus E1. So whenever we are applying the pumping energy to the ground state level, some of the atoms are going to the excited state and they are sitting on the excited state. But since we know that the lifetime of the atom to be on the excited state is only going to be 10 power minus 8 seconds. It is a very rapid time, so they will not going to be on the excited state for a longer time, and they will immediately come back to their ground state after living their lifetime of 10 power minus 8 seconds. So when they are coming back down to the ground state, they will emit a photon. They will emit a photon of H nu, which is by through a spontaneous emission. So they will emit a photon by spontaneous emission. There is one more emission is called, which is called stimulated emission, but most probably we are not seeing the stimulated emission in a 2-level laser case, because here comes the drawbacks of the laser. Here comes the drawbacks of 2-level laser, why we are not able to see any perfect laser light in the case of 2-level laser system. Only spontaneous emissions are there. Why? Because whenever we are, if we are having 100 atoms on the ground state level, and we are applying the pumping energy, so out of 100 atoms, in order to create the population inversion between the two energy levels, we have to take 51 atoms to the excited state. So in order to pump the 51 atoms to the excited state, it takes a more pumping energy is needed. First of all, we require a more pumping energy to at least pump the 51 atoms to the excited state. And the next drawback is, after all, we are pumping the 51 atoms to the excited state, but since the timing of the excited state, the lifetime of the atoms is only going to be 10 power minus 8 seconds. So any time, if we see at any time constant, the population will be constant on both the levels. The population inversion state is only not created here in the 2-level system, because if we are taking the 51 atoms here, they are immediately coming down. So at any particular point of time, we are not able to see any population inversion state here. That's why we are not able to get any lasing action here. So these are the two drawbacks. So first drawback was that we require more pumping energy for the atoms to be pumped to the higher excited state, which is nothing but E2. And the second drawback that we are facing is that at any particular time, we are not able to achieve the population inversion between the two states, because at any time we are having the same population on E1 and E2. That's why if the population inversion state is not created, we can't able to get our lasing action.
So how these two drawbacks are resolved in the three level case? So this is energy level E1, energy level E2, and energy level E3. So here also E1 is our ground state, which is having the population of the atoms N1. E2 is the metastable state, which is newly introduced state. So we are only changing your two level system to your three level system by introducing a one more additional state, which is called a metastable state. And this is the number of population of the atoms on the E3 level, which is a normal excited state, is going to be N3. So this particular E2 level of yours is a metastable state. So what a metastable state does? This is going to be a metastable state. This is a normal ground state that we have seen in the earlier case also. And this is a normal excited state. So the lifetime of on the excited state of the atoms is going to be 10⁻¹ second. And the lifetime on the E2 level will be going to 10⁻³ seconds to 10⁻⁵ seconds. So what is happening here? Even the metastable state, what it is doing to the three level system, whenever the atoms are coming to the metastable state, they are getting accumulated in the metastable state. And once they are getting accumulated, we are able to get a population inversion state between E1 and the E2 levels. So how we are getting? Suppose initially always your ground state atom will be full of the, your ground state level will be full of atoms. Right? After your ground state is full of atoms, we are applying the pumping energy to the ground state level, and after applying the pumping energy, there will be some atoms which will be going to be excited onto the excited state. And since there is only 10⁻¹ second lifetime they are going to live there, they will come automatically, or they will come rapidly down here, and they will settle on the metastable state. But since we are taking the atoms to the E3 level, they will also come back to the E1 level by a spontaneous emission. By spontaneous emission, the E3 atoms also have a chance to come back to the ground state level, and some atoms also have a chance to come to the metastable state. But this particular transition from E3 to E2 will be a non-radiative transition. It is going to be a non-radiative transition. The transition is only going to be emit heat, but not the light. Non-radiative transition. So whenever we are applying the pumping energy to the atoms which are present on the ground state, we are going to take the atoms from the ground state to the excited state. And after taking them to the excited state, they have only two options. Either they will come to the ground state as emitting a spontaneous emission, or either they will come down to the metastable state by emitting a non-radiative transition, which is nothing but a heat energy which is released, but not a photon here. But what different is happening here? And how we are able to resolve the drawbacks of the two level laser. So this is the before. This is the diagram which is before accumulation of the atoms in the metastable state. What happens when we have accumulated atoms on the metastable state? So when we have accumulated the atoms on the metastable state, then there are going to be more number of atoms on the metastable state, and the less number of atoms on your ground state. So here, after we have created a population inversion between E2 and E1, and how we have created? Because we have increased the time period of the E2 state. And how we have increased? There is nothing to increase. Actually, this is a metastable state. So it is automatically known that the atoms are going to live here, are going to have a lifespan of 10⁻³ seconds, right? So here they will have, only 10⁻⁸ seconds. So all the atoms which are on the level E3 will be having two options. Either they will come to the ground state by emitting a spontaneous emission, either they will come to the metastable state. Once they start accumulating on the metastable state, then we automatically know that between E1 and E2, we have achieved a kind of population inversion state. When we have achieved between E1 and E2 a population inversion state, So how we are getting the stimulated emission here? First, there will be a spontaneous emission. The first transition which this atom is going to transit here will be a spontaneous emission, where h nu is equals to E2 minus E1. The first atom which is going to be making a transition to the ground state will be having a spontaneous emission, and this spontaneously emitted photon will trigger the atoms, it will trigger or it will stimulate the atoms which are sitting on the excited state, and once it triggers the atom, they will come down to the ground state before completion of this time period. So once it triggers the atom which are sitting on the metastable state, they will also come down before completing their lifetime of 10 power minus 3 seconds, and we will be having two photons, h nu and h nu, and these two photons which are emitted are in the coherence, are in same phase, same amplitude. That's why in a 3 level laser case, we are able to get a lasing level here, lasing action here. And a 3 level laser, example of 3 level laser system is a ruby laser. Is a ruby laser in which the wavelength of the laser system is approximately 6328 angstrom. 6328 angstrom. 6328 angstrom. So suppose, what is the drawback we are getting in the three laser, level laser here? So see, if I had taken suppose 100 atoms on the ground state. If I have taken 100 atoms on the ground state. Now, if we are able, if we have to create a population inversion between E2 and E1, at least there should be 51 atoms present on the metastable state and 49 atoms on the ground state, because always the population of the atoms should be more on the metastable state than the ground state. So, in order to pump 51 atoms, I need a more pumping power. I need more pumping energy. In order to pump these 51 atoms to the excited state and then they will come to the metastable state, in order to pump these 51 atoms, we need more pumping energy. So the only drawback that we are having in the three level laser system is the more pumping power is required. So why we need more pumping power? Because we are getting a population inversion state between E1 and E2 levels. In order to get a population inversion state here, at least we should have, if we are having 100 atoms here, because at any time the number of atoms in the system are fixed. If we are having initially 100 atoms in the ground state, so in order to create the population inversion, we have to take 51 atoms to the metastable state. When here it is 51, here it is 49, then only the population inversion state is created between E2 and E1. And between which two levels we are getting a population inversion state, those two levels are called lasing levels. So E1 and E2 are called the lasing levels, between which two levels we are achieving a stimulated emission and a laser action is achieved. A laser action is there. Those two levels we call as a lasing level actions. But here the only drawback that we are seeing here, in order to pump the 51 atoms to the metastable state, we are requiring more pumping power. That's why we have a drawback in the case of a 3 level laser system also. But in the 4-level system, how we are resolving the more pumping power drawback here? We are using 4 levels here. 4 levels, obviously. This is E1, E2, E3, and E4. Sorry, I have to start with this. E1, E2, E3, and E4. So this is again the ground state level, this is again my ground state level, this is just a normal excited state level, this is just a normal excited state level, this is a metastable state here, metastable state, and this is also an excited state. Here, how we are able to resolve this drawback here? I am taking a metastable state here and excited state here. So in this case of 4 level laser system, I am creating the population inversion between metastable state E3 and the excited state level E2. So once I am creating the population inversion between E3 and E2, I don't have to bother about your ground state. Suppose initially if I take even the 100 atoms initially, if there are 100 atoms on the ground state, if the population of the number of the atoms on the ground state are 100, I need not to take 51 atoms. I need not to take half of the atoms to the upper state. I can only go with 20 atoms. I can only take 20 atoms. I can only pump 20 atoms to the excited state. And once the 20 atoms are pumped to the excited state, they will be having three options to come down. Either they will be coming back to the ground state by emitting a spontaneous emission. Either they will come down to the E2 excited state by having one more spontaneous emission. Or they will come to the metastable state by having a non-radiative transition. So always your non-radiative transition doesn't emit a photon there. Non-radiative transition. It is only a heat is emitted. No photon is emitted. So how we are able to resolve the drawback of more pumping power? We are not taking here the 51 atoms to be pumped to the excited state. Only I am taking 20 atoms to be pumped. If I am taking 20 atoms to the excited state, now what I am doing, only 20 atoms, first the whole 20 atoms will fall here. Suppose, from the excited state, if all the 20 atoms are falling here, and suppose the 5 are falling here, and the 15 atoms are falling here, the 5 atoms are falling here. Actually, they are not falling, they are transiting. They are making transitions. So 5 atoms are coming here, 15 atoms are coming here. Still, if I am having 15 here and 5 here, I am able to achieve the population inversion between E3 and E2. So, but what I am in the case of the 3-level laser, we have to take at least 51 atoms to the excited state in order to create the population inversion. So 51 atoms to be pumped has require more pumping power, and in the case of the 4-level laser system, I am only pumping 20 atoms. If I am only pumping 20 atoms, if you are pumping less atoms, then it requires only less pumping power to be used. If I am only pumping the 20 atoms to the excited state, only suppose 15 atoms are falling here and the 5 atoms are making transitions to the level E2, you are achieving a population inversion between E3 and the E2. E3 is your metastable state and E2 is your excited level. So in this excited, E3 level, the atoms are going to stay for 10 power minus 3 to 10 power minus 5 seconds because it is a metastable. But in the case of E2, they are going to be staying for a very little lifespan, which is 10 power minus 8 seconds. So once I am achieving a population inversion state between E3 and E2, I can get easily the lasing action by a similar procedure which I have shown here. First, one atom will be emitting a spontaneous transition here. One atom will be having a spontaneous transition. It will emit spontaneous photon, and that particular spontaneous photon will trigger the atoms which are sitting on this metastable state. It will trigger the already sitting atoms on the metastable state, and then we are able to get more photons of h nu. Then we are able to get h nu photons which are in the same phase, same phase, same amplitude, which is in a coherent manner, and those two particular photons which are emitted are coherent photons, and that's why we are able to get a laser, because there a stimulated emission is happening. This particular atom which is transiting from the having a transition from E3 to E2 is spontaneously emitted. First, a spontaneous transition has been made, and this particular spontaneously emitted photon will stimulate the atoms which are sitting on the excited state. Once it stimulates the atom which are sitting on the excited state, those particular atoms will come back to the E2 level before completing the lifetime of 10 power minus 3 seconds. So what is the meaning of the stimulation here? Whenever any atoms which are already present on the excited state, if they are getting stimulated without completing the full lifetime of 10 power minus 3 or 10 power minus 5 seconds, they will come down to your E2 level. Once they are coming to your E2 level, that means they are making a stimulated emission. First, a spontaneous emission has been made, and due to that spontaneous emission, it is making the other atoms to go stimulated emission, and this stimulated emission is producing the two coherent photons, which is h nu and h nu, and those two coherent photons is producing a laser light. So if again we will look back to the two second level pumping scheme, 3-level pumping and 4-level pumping scheme, we use the 4-level pumping scheme in case of helium neon laser. In case of helium neon laser system, you use a 4-level pumping scheme. So after achieving the 4-level pumping scheme, at a 4-level laser, we are not having any drawbacks. So we have resolved every drawbacks. So in the second level laser, we were having the 2 drawbacks, which is of higher pumping energy required. And the one more drawback was there, that we are at any time, we are able to get only the same number of atoms on both the states. Once the same number of atoms are there, there is no population inversion. So these are the 2 drawbacks in the case of 2-level laser. And how we have resolved in the 3-level laser, we are only able to resolve the one drawback, that we are able to create the population inversion state here. And the another drawback is as same. We require a more pumping energy here also. But in this case, both of the drawbacks of the more pumping power and the population inversion state, we are successfully resolving both of the two drawbacks here. Thank you. This is all about different types of pumping schemes of the laser.